Hello everyone, this is Christo from Balkan Ecommerce. Nice to see you all. Hello Vikren, can you hear us?
Hello Christo, yes indeed.
Hi. Okay, so thank you everyone for coming today. As usual, we are continuing our webinar series about e-commerce in Europe in particular. Today we will talk about some of the emerging markets for the continent, especially focused on the Central and Eastern Europe region. My name is Hristo Radicev and I am the co-founder of Balkan Ecommerce. Together with me today it is Vihren Biset and he is the sales manager. Our goal today is to discuss with you some tips that we have found over time about how you can benefit from the emerging e-commerce markets. You will know today which are these markets, what to do with them. Of course, we will first introduce ourselves and then we will continue according to the agenda that you are seeing on your screen. Just a few remarks before we go on. Some of you that have attended the previous webinar might find some of the slides being familiar. This is especially because we want to re-emphasize on the importance of the data that we are presenting. But of course, our goal today is to dive deeper into the emerging markets for Central and Eastern Europe, and to provide you some more in-depth specifics about courier delivery. This is the reason why I invited Vihren, because he is the most experienced person in this field in our team. Of course, we will discuss some localization and payments issues that are common for our region. And we will try to present you two interesting case studies about recent projects that we either are about to launch or have launched recently. And of course, at the end of the webinar, we have a traditional bonus for everybody who have attended our online meeting. So first, let us introduce ourselves. Vihren, you are first.
Yes, thank you, Christo. So hello, everyone. It's a pleasure to be here and to be able to provide some useful information, I hope. My name is Vihren Biset, and I am the team member at Balkan Ecommerce, who is responsible for the logistics services. So fulfillment, last mile deliveries, and all the shipping methods. This is what I manage.
And I am Christo, as I told you. I have some marketing background. I'm working with the international clients that we currently have in Balkan Ecommerce. And my specialization, so to say, is in the e-commerce strategy. It is very nice to see you. This is a very brief summary about the Central and Eastern European region. This is a slide that we had from the previous webinar. And I have put it here intentionally because when you consider selling in Central and Eastern Europe, my recommendation usually is to consider the region as a whole. And the reason behind this is that because of the geographical proximity between countries, now it is relatively easy to move items from one point to another. Whether you are in Greece, in Romania, in Hungary, in Czech Republic, or somewhere else, the e-commerce development allows you to sell cross-border. So if you plan a good strategy, it is quite possible that you can expand your market and your market audience, not by limiting yourself into one single country, but in more countries. Of course, this is not as easy as it sounds, but in fact, it is much easier compared to what we have several years ago. The whole region represents a total population of more than 120 million people. We have more than 70 million people who have shopped online something in the last 6 to 12 months. And you can see that it represents quite a big e-commerce turnover. And also the growth is much higher compared to the so-called developed countries. I would say that in the region, the most developed countries are Austria and the Czech Republic, but there are some markets that are well worth your attention simply because their growth is expected to continue being very high. And at the same time, the market size is relatively good so that you can benefit from more and more people shopping online and thus expanding your audience. We have chosen four of the countries to talk about today. They are Greece, Romania, Hungary, and Bulgaria, because they are the countries within the region, together with Croatia, but Croatia is a bit smaller, that's why we decided not to emphasize on it. But these countries are expected to grow on a compound rate between 2020 and 2024 by more than 10%. In some cases, this percentage is even higher, especially Romania and Bulgaria are growing at a very high speed. Of course, this is because of the lower level these markets are developing from. But Hungary and Greece are also quite interesting in terms of potential growth and potential for expansion. And when you think about it, if you put these countries together, within 3 to 4 days, you are able to move your items from one point to another. That's why we will talk about strategy when planning where to position your products and where to put them in order to spread them around cross-border. But there are also many other reasons to consider these markets. First of all, lower competition compared to Western Europe. And this is more and more valid for the emerging markets because there are still many niches that are not occupied. Of course, labor cost is, especially in Bulgaria and Romania, is lower. At the same time, the quality of people in terms of technical abilities, in terms of experience and so on are quite high. I would say above average compared to the whole Central and Eastern Europe. And still you have lower marketing and operation costs compared to Western Europe and more developed countries. Of course, the high growth we already mentioned, but also the opportunity to move fast items from one point to another gives you a good advantage if you put your stock in one of these countries and sell in the others. And this will not increase significantly your operational costs. A bit of statistics. In this chart, you can see the population on each of these markets. Of course, Romania is the biggest one, but it doesn't mean that the e-commerce market is biggest in Romania. In fact, the biggest e-commerce market is in Greece. And you can see that in terms of e-shoppers, again, Romania is around 5 to 6 million people and growing. These are statistics from 2019. And you can bet that the growth of each country varies between 20 and 30%. So now Romania could be well above 6 million people, Greece the same, Hungary the same, and for Bulgaria, I think the real growth is around 35%, 30 to 35%, although the official statistics shows that Bulgaria grew up by only 8%. But there is a reason behind this. In Bulgaria, the methodology of measuring the market is also including booking platforms like booking.com, like Airbnb, and so on. And all of you know what happened with the tourism last year. That's why the sharp decrease in these touristic services is also reflected in these statistics. While in the other countries, these booking services are not considered to be part of the e-commerce business. That's why they are showing a bit of higher increase. But the biggest courier now in Bulgaria for the last year grew up but by 23%. And there is no other explanation about that besides e-commerce. That's why the rough estimations are that Bulgaria grew up by 30 to 35% last year. Of course, when we have the final and official statistics, we will share them with you. It will happen somewhere in the next webinars that we are planning. Now let's have a look at the growth rate. You can see that Hungary grew up by 14% in 2019, but again for 2020, the growth everywhere varies between 22 to 30, 35%. That's why all the countries that we are monitoring right now are considered to be quite attractive for any who wants to develop his e-commerce business. As I told you, the Greek market is the biggest one in terms of turnover, almost 8 billion euro, followed by Romania, Hungary, and Bulgaria is for sure trespassing the threshold of 1 billion euro back in 2020. And for 2021, I think it will grow by 1.5 billion euro. So all of them are quite interesting from this perspective. Vihren, I will give you the word now because this is your domain, courier deliveries. So can you please say a bit more about what is more specific for the region and what are your impressions about this?
Yes, thank you, Christo. Obviously, one important factor in the whole e-commerce business is how you're going to fulfill and deliver your orders. Every country in Europe has its specifics, but since we are focused a lot on the Balkans, on Eastern Europe, we have a lot of experience here. We have, debugged the solution. So we have tested many, many couriers and many shipping methods just to find out over the years which will work best and which are most preferred by the customers. Here on the slide, you can see some important factors regarding the deliveries in the Balkans and Eastern Europe as a whole. Something you have to remember it is that the favorite payment method is cash on delivery. So basically every website that wants to be competitive and properly localized has to offer this option on the checkout. Now the percentage of cash on delivery shipments compared to all the shipments as a whole is different in each country, and but it varies between 50 and 65%. And in some specific spheres like fashion industry, shoes, and kind of lower value items, the cash and delivery percentage can be even more than 90. So you have to take into consideration how you're going to receive your cash and delivery payments, what currency, what bank account. This is all things we can help you with as an experience provider in the sphere. Now, about the last mile delivery experience, what is important that kind of in contrast to Western Europe, where you have these big multi-country carriers like DHL, DPD, GLS, these big networks, and most of the countries in Eastern Europe, there are local couriers who operate primarily in one single country, and they're actually the preferred and most reliable and most the option that most of the consumers actually prefer and expect. We have these big national couriers like Econt in Bulgaria, FAN in Romania, ACS in Greece, which are really market leaders. So in order to be localized as much as possible, it is best if you use the local couriers, the good established local couriers. About the cash and delivery, after the cash and delivery, of course, we have the issues of currency, and it is important to take into consideration that almost every Eastern market has a separate currency, and some countries use the euro, such as Greece, but most of them have a local currency. So you have to take into account when making your cost calculations the costs of actually having to exchange currencies. About the delivery preferences of the customers, for most spheres, we see that between 2 and 4 days is perfectly enough. Rarely people are expecting 24-hour delivery, especially in countries like Greece, which are have a lot of remote areas, islands, which are difficult to reach. And these customers, they do not expect 24-hour delivery. But we do offer different shipping methods in case you want to actually give your customer the choice to choose an express shipment for 24 hours at a high cost or a lower cost, but not so fast transit time shipment. So this is all benefits that you can integrate into your checkout very easily and have your customers very happy by the fact that they can choose how to receive their orders. And one of the last points is that the fastest merchant usually gets the deal. Here we're referring to some habits of the customers in Eastern Europe, which are based on the fact that they prefer cash and delivery. Very often they order the same or similar items for many online stores. And basically the one that delivers first, they pay the shipment, receive it, and refuse all the rest. This is quite unpleasant for the online stores very often, but it's a fact that we have to work with and find ways to overcome by offering faster deliveries, customer support, calling your recipients to make sure they're going to receive it and be at the address at the specified time and so on. And the final point here is, apart from the shipping, it is very important to think about where you're going to locate your stock. So a centralized warehouse somewhere on the Balkans or in Eastern Europe can allow you to ship very fast at the price of a domestic courier delivery to the all of Eastern Europe. So we have developed a network of such fulfillment hubs, starting from Athens, Sofia, Ruse, Bucharest, Hungary, and even Warsaw. And depending on the target countries and the cost and transit time ratio we're looking for, we can choose the best solution for each online seller. Christo, do you have anything to add?
Yes, I just wanted to add that because of this proximity, as I mentioned before, shipping from one warehouse, it is fine from a cost point of view, but you can think about accepting returns in more than one country. That will also cut down your courier costs. Because, for example, if you ship something from Sofia and it goes to Bucharest and to Budapest or to Hungary and Romania, you will have most probably some returns because of the cash on delivery. Cash on delivery usually has bigger returns because it is the most convenient option for the customer, because customers are not bound by any prepayments and so on, so they can easily return the parcel. In order to optimize this cost, it is good to consider a local warehouse in each of the countries to accept the return shipments for you, and then to send them back consolidated to the point of shipment where you are located. And this is a good practice that we are already implementing in several warehouses and several clients. Let's move on to the next slide. It is delivery time. We have presented here a rough estimation about delivery times that you can expect. Of course, these are average time frames, and of course there are exceptions depending on whether you have big sized items, do you ship to some specific areas. As Vihren mentioned, in Greece we have remote areas, islands, and so on. It is one thing to ship to the main city or the big cities. It is another thing to ship to some villages, and people are getting more and more experienced in e-commerce also in smaller areas, although you can expect around 30 to 35% of all the sales to come from the biggest city in each country. This is what our experience is showing, and even more depending on the type of the market. Vihren, do you have something to add here about expected delivery times and destinations?
Yeah. I have 2 points here to add, Christo. First of all, on the left side of the screen, you see Sofia, Athens, Ruse, Budapest, Bucharest. These are our fulfillment hubs. What is important, no matter if the online seller uses one, two, or all of these, he works in one single software interface and through one single integration. So we have very often the case where we start working with an online shop who wants to sell in one country, let's say Romania, we put their stock in Bucharest, we start working for Romania, and in 6 months they want to open a new market. This actually happens in a matter of hours. We do some settings in their account and they can send stock to Sofia, Ruse, Budapest, or wherever they want without any changes required on their side in the API or the software or anything. So this is very, very scalable, a very scalable solution. The second point regarding the transit times here, what you see is the combination each warehouse to each delivery destination. This is our standard courier road delivery service. We also, as I said previously, we also offer a 24-hour delivery air express service. So it is 24 hours to the whole of Europe, which means that if your client in Poland is okay to wait, let's say 5 days to receive his parcel, okay. But on the checkout, you can allow him to choose a 24-hour delivery at a slightly higher cost. So this again means great flexibility and a lot of value added to your clients.
And this is especially important if you are selling high-end products at a high price, where the increased cost for delivery wouldn't be so impactful regarding the decision of the sale.
Yeah, exactly.
Okay. So you have this overview. We have mentioned just a few of the countries that we are able to deliver to. Of course, if you are interested in some particular country, just give us a sign and we will discuss later on about deliveries to this particular country. It can be somewhere in Western Europe, it can be somewhere in Central Europe, and so on and so on. When it comes to regional channels to consider, you have to bear in mind that there are strong local players all around Central and Eastern Europe, especially for the markets that are interesting for us. I would say that there are several strong competitors when it comes to marketplaces. EMAC is a very important player in Romania, Hungary, and Bulgaria. I would say that it is the strongest one in Romania. In Bulgaria, you can also rely on good sales, but it depends on the category where you are. In Greece, we have a former price comparison website that it is quite interesting. I heard about it I don't know, 5 or 6 years ago, when one of our clients selling smartphones told me that he is making a big portion of the sales in Scrooge, in this platform. It was a price comparison website, and he told me that only this channel is ensuring twice as much orders compared to Facebook and Google at twice lower price. So it is really important in which category you are. Of course, things change over time and you cannot expect the same result right now, but it is good to not to ignore the local strong players. It is the same when it comes to email marketing, where, for example, in Bulgaria, we have a very strong local player, abv.bg, where I would say 80% of the B2C databases are in have emails in abv.bg. And if you don't optimize your email strategy to this particular email provider, you would not harvest such good results from your email marketing efforts as you would have if you paid enough attention on it. Of course, you can use other digital marketing channels like advertising networks like Etarget or AdWise, which is also another local option. Of course, with Etarget, you can go in more than one country. AdWise is strongly local, but you have to bear in mind that there are, of course, certain alternatives compared to traditional big players like Facebook, Google, and okay, Amazon is not present here in our target countries, but many customers are buying from either Amazon or AliExpress. In fact, Amazon and AliExpress are some of the most popular websites to buy from in some of the countries. So you should keep in mind that there are local alternatives, and you should focus part of your marketing efforts towards them.
Can I jump in, Christo?
Yes, of course. Go ahead.
As Christo said, the dominant marketplace in Romania, Hungary, and Bulgaria is eMAG. And a lot of online sellers rely only on it, actually, for most of their revenue. What we developed at the beginning of this year is a full software integration between our logistics platform and the eMAG marketplace, which means that the online seller can use any of our warehouses and shipping options, and the data between the eMAG platform and us is exchanged automatically. Variable generation, uploading of orders and statuses, they're all transferred automatically between the marketplace and us. So your business in eMAG, the logistics part, is basically on autopilot when working with our software solution.
Thank you, Vihren. So we have also four different languages for translations. You should keep this in mind, because depending on the number of products that you have, it could be something very difficult to do your translations, or it can be relatively easy. Of course, we recommend to cover as many languages as possible, because not all of the customers are speaking English. Of course, there are exceptions, and I will tell you later on about one exception that we have worked on in order to go faster on the market. And then our strategy is to localize for each market depending on the results. We have four different currencies, and that means that you should find out a way to optimize costs. One of the way to optimize costs when it comes to exchange of money, of currencies, and payments is to check for reliable fintech solutions. There are several players on the market that allow multi-currency account. And this way, you can accept the money in the same currency that you have received them. And you can optimize a lot on exchange rates and transaction costs this way. We provide fulfillment warehouse in all the countries that we are discussing right now, and in different cities, so you can be relatively flexible when it comes to where to put your items. Of course, this is something very important that enters into force from 1st of July, the so-called one-stop shop for VAT. That means that if you are an e-commerce player and you ship your items from, let's say, one place, let's say Romania, and you sell to end customers located in other countries, you should declare on quarterly basis the VAT depending on the destination country. So let's assume you have 100 euro in sales and you have to declare 20 euro for VAT. Out of these 100 euro, 50 euro are in Romania. And that is okay, you should declare the VAT there. But also you have 20 euro to declare, let's say, in Hungary, and 30 euro to declare in Bulgaria. In this case, with the one-stop shop, you make a single registration in your local authority responsible for handling taxes. You pay the VAT deemed for the different countries in one place. And from then on, your local authority is responsible to spread out the money towards different countries depending on the report that you have prepared. And this is done on a quarterly basis, and it is a convenient thing for most e-commerce players, because this way you shouldn't register in each of the countries once you jump over the threshold. As you know, for distance selling, so far we had different thresholds in different countries. Now, above 10,000 euros sold within a European Union, you should either register in each country where you have clients, or you can register once in the one-stop shop. Of course, this is valid only if you are shipping from one point. That's why I told you that it is increasingly important to ship in this region from one single point in order to save on paperwork. Because if you have, for example, two or three or four warehouses within all the four countries, that means that you have to register under VAT in each of the countries, find a local accountant to deal with this, probably a lawyer, not probably, but for sure a lawyer. You should also pay some additional taxes. And from administrative point of view, this is quite, inconvenient. Luckily, the one-stop shop allows you to ship from one country and declare everything there. And from then on, your local authority will have the task to distribute the VAT accordingly. And of course, last mile delivery courier is so important, as we said, because localization is what matters in these emerging markets. People prefer local couriers. They trust them, they like them, they like to pay cash, they like to pay in their local currency, and the couriers are well suited to accept this cash on delivery and to process it. And the logic is that we are collecting from all the couriers the cash on delivery, and we are streamlining this to the to our customer. This way you will not receive money from different couriers and different suppliers. You will receive all the money consolidated in one place. Bihren, you can correct me if I said something wrong, but I think it is the model that we follow.
Yes, exactly. As Chris said, all the local couriers, at the moment we work with more than 30 last mile couriers. We have tested more than double this amount, which means we already know which work best, which do not work best, the different quality and the strengths and benefits of each courier. This is all integrated into one single solution along with the fulfillment service. So you only have one software interface to work in. And also we are very flexible on the COD payments. We collect from other countries and transfer them in the currency that you want. So either the local currency or euro, which is very often what the online shops need.
Yes. As I told you, we have a case study for you. The first one is a project that it is about to start. We expect to have it launched in the next two or three weeks. It is a website selling beer accessories. The countries that we will cover are Bulgaria, Greece, Hungary, and Romania, and other countries, because we will launch it simultaneously in several countries. In order to save on time to market, we decided to go with a different strategy with this project. We will launch only prepaid. So only credit cards will be accepted, only euro, in order to jump to the market and quickly test it. And then based on the response that we get, we will localize the countries one by one. Of course, we will start with the country that we get the highest response based on the customer preferences. And the services that we have related to this project is pretty much everything. We have the preliminary market research done by our team. We have the order fulfillment done in, organized in Sofia. We have the customer service also organized in our office in Sofia from our call center. The courier delivery is cross-border, so we can ship to Sofia, from Sofia to Bulgaria, to Romania, to Greece, to Hungary, and so on. As I told you, we will accept returns in local warehouses and we will deal with them. We will take care of the digital marketing, and we even take care of the product pictures, because we have a very professional partner to do the pictures for the websites with. The interesting about this project is that when you want to test many markets at once, you can follow the same strategy. You jump in all the markets, you target particular audience that is, for example, speaking English in this case, and then you decide where to continue and how to continue. Of course, there are other options then to open marketplaces. One of the easiest ways, by the way, to test a market is to just to list your product in a marketplace and to check how people will accept it. But of course, this is also dependent on your strategy and how, if you want to launch your brand first and then to offer it on the marketplace, or if you resell some non-branded products, you can give it a try the other way around. The other case study that we have is of a manufacturer of 3D puzzles from Romania. Our services in this case are only the order fulfillment and the courier delivery, and the countries are island countries, Greece and Cyprus. Because of the geography, the customer is not able to quickly move stuff from one point to another. That's why we have warehouse in each of the countries. Of course, there are different payment options. Cash on delivery is also in the list. And in this case, the B2B orders are more than the B2C orders. And in fact, the good revenue comes from local distributors who buy wholesale and then resell, or corporate clients who buy these products and sell them on the local market. Vihren, you have to add something, I think.
Yeah, just to add, Christo, this case study of the client selling 3D puzzles and modules is a very good example of the scalability of our solution that I mentioned previously. So they worked with us in our warehouse in Athens, delivering to Greece for, I think it was around half a year maybe, or slightly more. And when they decided to open Cyprus, the most logical solution is a local warehouse because this is an island. So we actually managed to open the warehouse for them in their account for a matter of hours, and they were ready to send some stock to Cyprus as well. So in the next few months, if they want to open a warehouse in Germany, Poland, Spain, or wherever, it's the same process. We do the settings, they send stock, and they're ready to start selling and delivering there.
In other words, we are doing everything that is behind the curtain, so to say. and the client takes care of the development of the product, the maintenance of the website, and so on. So here is the summary of the five tips that we have promised for you today. First, think about covering more than one market. And of course, you can cover all of them depending on the type of the products and your strategy. Deliveries are important. And the further you go east, the more important become the last mile delivery and the local courier. You should be fast, because otherwise with these cash on delivery specifics, which is quite typical for the region, somebody else who delivers faster will get the deal and you will get the return. And of course, you should consider the cost of this. Shall you fight for the fastest possible delivery, or if you have a unique product which is that has no alternative, you can allow yourself to be a bit slower. One point of shipping for these four countries could be enough because of the proximity and the relatively easy way to move stock. And beware of payments in different currencies, because it can be, at the end of the day, it can be quite costly for you, because not all traditional banks have these low fees. Of course, with the SEPA bank transfers, it is now easier to move from one euro account to another. But then the exchange rate differences and fluctuations would be a costly thing for you. And if possible, use the VAT one-stop shop from 1st of July. Of course, this is a much broader topic. I strongly suggest you to check how is the situation with your particular case, because there is one stop shop for distant sales. There is another one for companies that import directly from other countries. So you should pay attention and consult your local authority and local resources to learn more about the options that you have under the VAT one-stop shop. But from 1st of July, that would save you a lot of administrative paperwork, burdens, and so on. I personally think that this is a good and right move from the European Commission to consolidate this kind of operations into one point, And of course, if you are selling through a marketplace, you should have in mind that the obligation to declare the VAT is not yours, it is on the marketplace. Of course, there are also certain conditions to be met, but in most of the cases, the marketplace will hold the VAT instead of you and will declare it depending on the countries where you are selling your products. So keep an eye on this and investigate deeper. This is how we can help you. In fact, it doesn't matter how big you are, whether you are a huge online shop, one online shop, or you are a one-man show, we can help you solve so many business issues at once, because we really work right now in more than 10 European countries. If you work with us, you will get a dedicated contact person. Sometimes it will be even Vihren, because he is responsible for some of our big clients. We have different teams that are separate by services, so you can rely on expertise in each of these fields. And the single API integration, I think it is more than needed right now, because it allows you to be scalable, to be quick, and to not to waste time in unnecessary technical, focuses from your development team in order to adjust your platform or adjust your processes for the different countries. Of course, you get all the reports needed when it comes to transparency, so you know where do you have the stock, how many it is, how your operations are going, what is the return rate, how many shipments do you have today, based on products, based on countries, and so on. And your focus could be in developing your product, making it better, thinking about new products that you can introduce to the market, and taking care of the e-commerce platform that you are working with. It doesn't matter if it is software as a service or it is some open source or custom-made platform. I'm sure that every e-commerce merchant has a lot of things to think about. So some of the services can be easily outsourced, especially if you are not sure that this market can be successful for you. You can give us a try by outsourcing part of these services, and then you can optimize on some fixed costs as well. I don't know, Vihren, if you have to add something, but we can also help you with translation and adaptation of the website from many different languages into the local language.
Thank you, Christo. It's an excellent summary of what we do and how we can help. Basically, what I recommend is, if you have any plans or even ideas to sell, expand in a specific market or many markets at the same time, just get in touch. We'll discuss and we will let you know what is the best solution. Are we the best solution for you, or just how you should plan your ideas? We are quite flexible in our solutions. We do provide a lot of services which can be combined, or you can just use from our portfolio something that you really need at the moment. We can always add extra services, new warehouses, new destinations very easily.
Yes, and if we don't know quite well your sector, we can also help you by conducting on your behalf the local market research, because this is something that last year was quite often asked from clients. They came and they said, we want you to make a report for me. Of course, this has some fee related to it, but it is some useful information that helps the customer to make an informed business decision. And we conduct the so-called desk research with some information available in the local sources for each of the countries. We always use local people to do this research, and we conduct a report about main competitors, the size of the markets, the current trends, the most advertising strategies used by competitors, and so on and so on. So in fact, you can rely on us about many different things and consider us as being a one-stop shop for the different services that your business can outsource. Of course, now it is time to tell us about your online business. So we will be happy to answer all your questions. It will be good to send us some summary about what you are doing in 2 weeks from now, so we can process it. We can send you our honest feedback without hiding anything. And if we don't see a potential in this, we will just warn you, because there could be a hidden hurdle about this. Shortlisted businesses, of course, can receive from us 1 hour free consultancy over phone, over Zoom, face-to-face. Yesterday, we had a meeting with a very pleasant gentleman from Germany. So, of course, no strings attached. You can either decide to continue working with us or do it by yourself. But I'm sure that you will find many different benefits of relying on our services compared to doing everything by yourself, because it is more time consuming. You will have to learn and reinvent the wheel, so to say. So in other words, what we can do is just help you sell more, depending on the countries that you prefer to go to. Of course, we have prepared your bonus material. If you go on the short link shown there, and of course, we will also send you the presentation from the webinar shortly after it is over, in the next few days. You can directly download our ebook. It is quite well accepted, by the way, from all the people that managed to download it, because it gives very practical and reasonable tips when you go cross-border. So I strongly recommend you to read it and take advantage of it. We will shortly update it with some tips about one-stop shop VAT. And now it is time to share with us your questions, of course, if you have some. We are available to answer them if we can. Of course, if you prefer, you can send us an email shortly after, or you can call us over the phone, so we can discuss more about your business. Of course, you can use either the Q&A module, or you can type your questions directly in the chat form that you have. Just to summarize, these 4 countries that we were talking about today, Bulgaria, Greece, Hungary, and Romania, are only some of the markets that you can expand to with our help. We can also help you for the Czech Republic, for Slovakia, for Germany, for France. We recently introduced a client in the French market, which is quite tough, of course. In Spain and in Portugal, we also have warehouses where you can use them and you can spread your parcels. Vihren can tell you more about all the different points and all the different options that you have for either fulfillment, for either courier delivery, and all the options.
I would need another webinar for that, Christo, but
yes.
Anyone who gets in touch, we will do our best to describe all the possible options which are constantly expanding. So we are always working on our solutions, adding new carriers, new features in our software, you know, to make life easier for the e-shops. So it's quite dynamic.
Yes. Okay. I don't see some questions. That could mean that either you have understood everything, or you didn't understand so much. So if needed, we can repeat it. Of course, you will shortly receive from us the record of the webinar plus the presentation that we have used today. And of course, if something in between pops up to your mind, if you have any questions related to the region or to e-commerce in general, just come back to us and we will be happy to help. So thank you very much. Thank you also, Vihren, for helping me today with the webinar. And we are accepting expecting your questions and your inquiries. Thank you, and I wish you a nice weekend, because it is shortly coming. Bye-bye. Thank you.
Bye-bye, everyone.